Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Spare Parts, and today I'll be doing an unboxing and review of set number 76403, the Ministry of Magic. This set came out in the year 2022 and comes with 990 pieces and retails for $100, but I got it as a deal at Target for $70. Let's see if it's worth it.
Taking a look at the box art, you can see that it's the normal Harry Potter box art that they've been using for the past, I think, 2 years? I'm not sure how long, probably a little longer. But anyway, on the front you can see that here is the set. And I see there's a big gap in the middle right here. I've heard people who have built the set complain that they don't like about the gap when it's finally built. I'll have to see if I agree with them or not. But over here, there's the telephone booth coming down. It's a nice background box art. It's other parts of the Ministry of Magic. It looks pretty good. And then we have our characters in the front doing their various things. Anyway, moving on to the sides. Just looks normal. Nothing really special about the sides, except for the top. We have a nice better look at the minifigures in the set. You can see Umbridge over there. I'm excited to see those minifigures. They look pretty good. Anyway, on the back, it gives us a better look at the interior of the set. Up here, we have some features it can do, like can show how Harry Potter can transform into the Ministry employees and how his friends can do that as well. Up here, they show how modular the set is. That looks pretty cool. And over here we have two offices, and then over here we have some more various play features, and here's a better look at the interior. Let's open it. This is a pretty big set, so I'll show my unboxing from this angle so you can take a better look. This set does use the tape and not the push tabs, thankfully, so it's a lot easier to open. Just kind of stick the scissors in. I kind of hold scissors pretty dangerously like this. I don't really know why I do that. It just works better. There, got one. Alright, there we go. Let's open. I'm guessing it's going to be a pretty normal unboxing experience. I'm not sure though. Yeah, looks like we have a bag. There's bag one. Bag two. That looks like bag three. And bag four. Pretty big box. Oh, look at that. That's very nice. The instruction manual. I'll get you a better look at that. The instruction manual is sealed and with the sticker sheet so it doesn't get bent. That's very nice. I really like that a lot. And then let's see what else is in the box. I think there's one more bag. Oh, bag number seven. Jeez, there's a lot of bags in this set. Here, I'm gonna dump the rest. Okay. Bag number six and bag number five. So looks like there's seven bags in the set. And then it also comes with this very nicely sealed instruction manual and sticker sheet. Very happy with that. Let's get building. So this is what the set looks like put together and built. And I think it looks a lot taller than I expected by looking at the box. I didn't know it was gonna be this tall. I wanted it to fit on that shelf right there. I wasn't sure if it was all gonna fit. So I think it's gonna be a really close call. But other than that, it looks really good. I really like the minifigure selection, and let's take a closer look. Since this is a bigger set, I'll be looking at each room separately and just going over like the play features and cool Easter eggs in each of them. So starting off, I will just start with the bottom ones here. Something I noticed about the set is it's really like unstable. Cause like that's what I mean. It has this top piece that kind of like puts it together when it's all stood up, but it doesn't have anything on the bottom, so it's kind of wobbly when it's all together. That's just something I noticed while messing around with the set. Starting off with the bottom room on the left tower, this is the Flu Network fireplace, or one of the places where the ministry officials arrive to work. And this has a pretty cool play feature where you place the minifigure in it, and you can actually kind of pretend that they're apparating or disapparating or whatever. And I think it's super cool. So you just place the minifigure right here in this little slot thing. And then on the back, there's a lever that you pull. So he just stands there and then you pull it. Where'd he go? He just apparated through the Flu Network. And I think that's super cool. It's kind of unfortunate that it takes up a whole, like one of these. I don't know. It's super cool though. Moving on up the left tower, next room is the interrogation room, or the interrogation room storage area. Because what it's supposed to be is it's supposed to be the scene where Umbridge is interrogating the muggles that work at the ministry. But you can't really use it as that because it won't fit if you try to put them in there with all these things in there. So you have to kind of take them out, and you're supposed to represent like the scene just on the floor. It's kind of cool. I'm glad they included this scene. But once you take it all out, you're just kind of left with an empty room, which I've been kind of using as just like a minister's office or something. Like I'll put the chair in there and then I'll put the minister in there. Let's see, where is he? Somewhere over here. Anyway, I just put him in there and I'd have like an extra office. It's kind of cool that it gives you some empty space, but I don't know. I feel like it could have been used better. The final part of the tower is Umbridge's office. So much like her office at Hogwarts, it has a bunch of those cat pictures on the walls, which I think look super cool. They are unfortunately stickers, but it's understandable. And you have a desk here that you can kind of remove. That's what I actually really like about this set, is it lets you remove a lot of things, like with that pass room, the interrogation chamber. It was kind of unfortunate that they didn't use it for something better, but it's still super cool that you can move the stuff around. And I think this is a great example of that, because you can kind of flip the desk and have her sit this way instead, which is like something they have on the box, where you can have them sit multiple ways. I think that's super cool. Here, I'll show you what it looks like with Umbridge in there. Just kind of sit her down. Or, man, the paper's getting in the way. Like that. So yeah, it's not that detailed, to be honest. Like on her desk, there's just like a teacup and like a paper, but it's still super cool. At the top of the tower, you were also supposed to add this roof piece right here. I think it looks pretty good. It represents the roof really well. I'm not really sure what this piece is all about. I mean, it adds something to the set, but I'm not really sure what it is. And this is one of those like bomb things Harry Potter uses to distract the people in that typewriter room. Super cool inclusion, and I think the roof looks pretty good. Moving on to the right tower, at the base of that tower there is this like newspaper area. I'm not really sure what this is supposed to be. I looked at some like pictures from the movie and there is actually like a pipe at the base of the tower things. I don't really know what it's for, but at least it's accurate. Although I do wish this was used for something better than just a newspaper area. Because, like, it's supposed to represent the scene where the newspapers go flying while, like, Harry Potter in his disguise is running away. And the way they do that is by having these knobs in the back that you press. And when you do that, like, the newspaper just, they kind of go flying. It's pretty cool. I mean, it's a nice play feature. I just kind of wish it was used for, like, maybe the elevator in the ministry. That'd be super cool to have more interior space. I feel like it's kind of wasted. Next up on the left tower, we have this room here. And this is, like, the room where the papers fly against the windows in the Deathly Hallows, because when they're escaping, they kind of send newspapers everywhere. It looks super cool. These are actually like printed window panes and they're not stickers, which is super awesome. They're all the same piece though, unfortunately, but I think it's super great that they're not stickers. But anyway, looking at the interior, we can see that, oh my gosh, it's actually the Department of Mysteries, which I think is super cool. Although it's kind of weird that there's just an Order of the Phoenix reference in the middle of a Deathly Hallows set, because you don't have like any of the characters from that to use here. But it's super cool. I'm glad they were using the space nicely. And there's also a play feature here where you can kind of spill the Wall of Prophecies by moving this diamond lever thing right here. And they fall. And I think that's super cool. It's a really nice play feature and a nice reference. The final room on the right tower, and my personal favorite, is Arthur Weasley's office. And just look at how many Easter eggs are in here. We have the Weasley's trip to Egypt, a rubber duck, a plane because his fascination with muggle stuff. We have a boombox, and so much more. I think it's super cool, all the things that are in here. And you can also move the desk, just like with Umbridge's, and put it the other way. But it's super cool. You can see there's like a tea kettle, a cup, a baby bottle. And then there's a clock over here, there's like a bottle, there's like a gem, there's a fork. It's really funny. I think wizards still use forks, right? I'm not really sure why he has a fork in his office, but that's super cool. I really like the rubber duck under the glass thing, it's super cool. And then there's a cup. But yeah, there's just a lot of things in here, and I think it's really good. Lego did a great job with this. And you can also put Arthur Weasley in the seat. Let me get him here. Oh, his hand came off, darn it. Whatever. You can just put him in here like this. Then yay, he's working at the desk. Anyway, it's super cool, and this is my favorite part of the set, probably. This tower also has a roof piece. It's basically the exact same as the other one. It has the weird green thing again, and it has that little bomb thing. The last part of the Ministry of Magic is the thing that connects them in the middle, or the last part of the buildings, I should say, because there is more to the set. But basically, this is just like the bridge that goes at the top, and it has this really nice banner piece that is so satisfying, the sway. I don't know why I find that so satisfying. It's just really cool. I have no idea why I like that so much. It's super awesome. But anyway, there is actually an interior on this, which it's kind of random, but I'm really glad they included, because this is like to represent the part where Harry Potter uses these bomb things to distract the typewriter people. So that's kind of why those were in the set, I'm guessing. But it's super cool. You can have a person sit here and kind of work on the typewriter. Oh my gosh, go on. I'll just put them right there. And then there's like a really nice typewriter build. I'm not sure if this is an illegal building technique or not. I actually don't know. You should let me know in the comments or not. I don't know. Like, because it's these like grabber pieces, and then there's a like slab that just goes in them, and it doesn't feel right. Like, it doesn't feel like it's something Lego would include in a lot of their sets. I don't know. Let me know if that's an illegal building technique or not. I think it is. I'm not sure. This piece connects rather simply to the top because all the towers have Technic holes in the sides. So you just kind of stick it in one. Come on. Though I guess one problem with it connecting is it uses the black Technic pins, not the gray ones, because the gray ones usually go in easier. Anyway, then you just do the same thing with the other one. And then it's all together. Super nice. And something I noticed with the set is it's actually at a 90 degree angle if you tilt it like this, which is something that it doesn't seem like at first, but it actually is. Like, this one's at a 90 degree angle to that one, which is super cool. I don't know. It's something that you don't notice at first, but it's actually kind of cool about the set. This set is also very modular, and it's meant to be that way. For example, you can just kind of take this thing off, and you can kind of customize your layout for these towers, like, because they have all the Technic holes in the sides, so you can kind of just stick them together if you wanted to, and you can make different layouts, which I think is super cool. I'm glad it's not just one layout, because in my opinion, some of them can look better than others. Like, this kind of looks cool. Like, you can just have, like, because I know some people don't like that gap in the middle that the set gives you, and having it like this can kind of fix that, so there's not as much gap. I don't know. I haven't really spent that much time trying to customize it, but there is an option to customize it if you would want to. Taking a look at the side builds of the set, starting off we have the Fountain of Magical Brethren, I think is what it's called. And in the movies, it just has this really impressive look of a bunch of different, like, magical species all up on this gold plate thing. And I think that it's very poorly represented here with just, like, one guy. I know that there's limits on what LEGO can put in, like, a set like this, but I still feel like they could have put, like, him over here and then another minifigure on the other side just to add it a little more depth or something. Like, I feel like it's missing something. It's nice that it's in the set, but I feel like they could have done it better. Next up is another great aspect of the set, and that is the telephone booth. And man, this looks amazing, doesn't it? Like, just look at that. I mean, there are some stickers, like these are stickers at the top, but this is all printed. Like, look at that. That's amazing. LEGO printed that for us. Thank you. I mean, look at how painful this would have been to apply. As, like, you've known from me before, I really hate door stickers, so this is just great. But anyway, on the inside, there is a telephone, and you can put minifigures in there, like this, and then you can kind of go up and down. And I did test it earlier. You can fit two minifigures in there. They're just, like, really cramped. I'll get one over here. Because that's kind of what happens when Harry goes down with Mr. Weasley. There's two, and you can fit them in there. It's just, it takes a little bit, and it doesn't look comfortable for each person. But anyway, it's a super cool telephone booth, and another thing that's great about it is it doesn't need to be in a Harry Potter build or, like, a display. Like, you could use it in just, like, a London build, because it's just a regular telephone booth. I think it looks amazing. Now on to minifigures, and boy, there are a lot of them. There's, like, it's crazy. Like, it's $100 and there's almost 10 minifigures. Like, that never happens anymore. But anyway, starting off, we have, oh man, I'm gonna need to get the box to look at the names of all these characters. Starting off, we have Albert Runcorn. Yeah, that's his name. And this is the guy Harry uses Polyjuice Potion to turn into when he's infiltrating the ministry. And a cool feature with him is you can actually take off his hair and twist the head and then put on Harry's hair to show, like, at the end of the scene when the Polyjuice Potion wears off and they're running away. And I think that looks really cool. And also his printing is pretty good. He has leg printing, which is great. It continues the torso printing. On the back, it's pretty basic, but still looks pretty cool. So overall, a great minifigure. Next up, we have Mafalda Hopkirk, I think is what her name is. And this is the witch that Hermione transforms into with the Polyjuice Potion. And you can also do the same with Harry. You can take off the hair, flip the headpiece, and then put on Hermione's hair, And look at that. Super cool. This one doesn't have leg printing, unfortunately, but I think it's okay because it's another just civilian minifigure. And overall, I think she looks pretty good on the back. We have a continued printing, and the suitcase doesn't have anything in it. It's just there for show. Next, we have Reg Cattermole, and he looks pretty good. He's pretty detailed on the top. I really like that torso printing because in the movie, he is fixing Yaxley's office, which has rain coming down, and you can see there's like the water marks at the top. It looks super cool. Like, look at the back. He's just drenched. He looks super cool. I really like the head printing. It looks pretty good to what we see in the movies. And you can also do the head swap thing. Just spin it around. Oh my gosh, his head is really on there. Jeez. Well, anyway, I'm just going to show you the back. You could just put Ron's hair on. And there you go. Super cool minifigure play feature, and I think it works really well with all of them. Now we have Arthur Weasley, and I think he looks pretty good at first glance, but the more I'm looking at him, I realize how basic his torso printing is. I kind of wish it was a little more exciting or a little more detailed. And there's no leg printing either, but I guess the head printing is pretty good, and the hair works. And he does have an alternate face that is kind of angry a little bit. I think that looks pretty good. And he also has a briefcase, which actually does have something in it. And I don't really get the reference, which is kind of weird, because I usually get Harry Potter references, but it has like a B in it. Not really sure why here. It's pretty small. It's like, yeah, let's see if I can get it to focus on the B. Come on. Yeah, it's that. I don't know really what this is supposed to represent, but he does have a B in his case. And another, there actually is a problem I have with it, and that is they made the suitcase in brown, and brown is known to be like a really weak Lego color. Like, it frays really easily, as you can see, like, on mine. There is, like, let me see if I can get it close to camera. There is, like, it's starting to fray already. Like, I've noticed this with the broom pieces they use, but it's kind of getting damaged, and I do not like that. I wish they would have used a different color. Next up, we have Mary Cattermole, and I think she looks pretty good. She has leg printing and torso printing, and it works really well with continuing on the top and the bottom, and I think it looks pretty good. And on the back, there's just some basic back printing. And she does have a second face, which is very accurate to what she's feeling in the movie, which when she's really scared of the Dementor and stuff. And I think it's a really good minifigure. Very nice detailing. Next up, we have Yaxley, or Corbin Yaxley. I did not know his first name was Corbin. But anyway, he looks pretty detailed. His torso is really nice for what we see in the scene. Doesn't have any leg printing, but I think the headpiece is really accurate, and his hair works really well. I think you could definitely tell that this is, like, if you saw the character in the movie and you saw this minifigure, you would definitely tell who he's supposed to be. I think he's really accurate. Oh, and one last thing. He unfortunately does not have a second headpiece or second face. Kind of interesting, because his hair would definitely cover it. I'm not really sure why Lego didn't give him a second face. Next, we have Dolores Umbridge and her cat Patronus. And I think we'll start with the cat Patronus. I think it's a really nice recolor for the cat mold. Looks super cool. I'm really glad it's included in the set. I really like the Patronus pieces. That's really great. And now looking at Umbridge, she has some really nice torso printing. Like, the cat scarf looks super cool. On the back, there's just some more stripes. And she doesn't have leg printing, but that's okay, because I think torso printing makes up for that. And then she has a nice hair piece. And then on the back, she has like a kind of surprised face. Looks pretty good. It works pretty well for the scene where Harry is busting out Mary Cattermole. So yeah, pretty good minifigure. Next up is Pius Thicknesse. That's a really weird name. But anyway, he's the Minister of Magic in the 7th movie. And I think he looks really good. The hair piece is really good. And his torso isn't that detailed, but it works for what we see in the movie. And yeah, his hair is super cool. I really like that piece. I don't know if it's exclusive or not, but it's a great piece. On the other side, we have this smile that looks kind of weird, but nice second face. And he also does have a brown briefcase. And inside this one, which is already starting to break, we have a time turner, which is super cool. A nice time turner piece. But anyway, I still had the same problem with the briefcase. It's just the minifigure hands, they kind of like rub on it and then it kind of breaks a little bit. It's also really hard to get it back in their hands once you take it out. So really the only major problem with these minifigures is the brown briefcase. Wow. Finally, we have a Dementor, and boy, does he look really good. I don't know if he's exclusive or not. I don't think he is, because I know there's been a Dementor in other sets, but
man, he looks really cool. I've never had one. And just look at the cape, like it has the holes in it and stuff. And then look at his torso, it has like the gross goo and ribs. And then his headpiece is like just a mouth. That's really creepy. But overall, I think this is a great minifigure. Like, just look at this. That looks super awesome. I don't know. I've never had a Dementor before, and I think this is a really great minifigure. Also included in the set are those two, are like two airplane things that like they send the messages in. I think it's super cool. I mean, there's no elevator for the message things to go in. Ahem. As you can tell, I really wish this set came with an elevator. But anyway, I think they look pretty good. It's a nice representation. They are a little bit oversized, but they work great. Moving on to stickers and prints. This might take a while because there are not that many stickers, but there are a lot of prints. Starting off with the telephone booth, this is printed. Thankfully, I couldn't imagine that being a sticker. But these are all stickers, unfortunately. You had to do it four times to telephone. But yeah, that's all stickers and prints on that. There's no stickers or prints on this fountain thing. Moving on to the build, let's start with the base. These are all prints, these Harry Potter like newspaper pieces. That's super cool. I'm glad those weren't stickers. And then on to the back. No prints or stickers on this side and not on this side. So I will try to take this apart to show you each part. Here, I'll just take the camera with me. Anyway, moving up. This room does not have any stickers or prints, but on the other side, these pieces, the window pieces, are actually prints on like the window pane pieces, which is super cool. And then up above that, oh my gosh, this room has a lot. This is a sticker. This is a sticker. This is a print. This boombox, I think, is printed. I'm not really sure if that counts as print. Like, there's a bunch of stuff on it. So yeah, there are a lot of stickers and prints up there. And then moving on to the other side. Well, we'll look up here first. This is a sticker for the typewriter. And then over here, this set is really difficult to move. I will just say that this set needs some stability, like especially on the bottom. I wish there was something connecting it because it's so difficult to move. It always falls apart. Anyway, up here, this is a sticker. That's a sticker. There's like these bullet point sticker pieces. And then in Umbridge's office, this is a sticker. That's a sticker. That's a sticker. That's a sticker. Man, there's more stickers than I remember. Jeez. And then moving on to the side over here. Yes, this is just so difficult to move. Oh my gosh. This is a sticker, and that is a sticker. This was a pain to apply. Oh my gosh. I accidentally applied it upside down, so it said W instead of M, and then I had to take it off and reapply it. That was an absolute nightmare. I don't recommend doing that. But anyway, there's a lot more stickers than I remember, and there are some decent prints, though. There are also some small prints that go in, like, suitcases and hands. First one is Salazar Slytherin's locket, which is supposed to go with Umbridge. I think that's super cool. It's a nice printed piece. Then there's that random Bumblebee piece. Yeah, I don't really know what this is for, but it's in the set. Then we have the Time Turner piece, which isn't exclusive or new, but I think it still looks pretty good. All right, weak parts time. To be honest, the whole set is a weak part. As you can see by me moving it, it falls apart a lot because it's supposed to be modular like that, but that means it's not the best stability-wise. Like, it falls apart all the time. But other than that, I wouldn't say there's a lot of weak parts. Maybe these, but they don't really fall off ever. So overall, like, not that many weak parts, but overall the set is a weak part, if that makes any sense at all. All right, time to discuss accuracy to the movies. So overall, I think it's really accurate. This color scheme is just what we see in the movies, and the minifigures are really accurate as well. And I know some people complain about the big gap in the middle and how it just looks empty. Well, that's accurate. Like, that's how it looks. I feel like if you put like a Dementor or two in there to fill it out, like just to add something, it would look a lot better. But that's just kind of how it looks. The one thing that might not be accurate, I'm not really sure, is the typewriter up there, because I don't think that there's just like a random typewriter. And also these green pieces, I'm not really sure what they're supposed to represent. So maybe I'll give it a 9 out of 10 for accuracy. Like, the color scheme's there, and I think it represents it very well. Alright, price per piece time. So, if you were to buy this at Lego.com, I'm pretty sure it was on sale for a little bit for like $70, but at retail price, it's $100. So that would be around 10 cents per piece with 990 pieces. So I would say that's a okay price per piece. There are some bigger pieces in here, like at the top, there's some big pieces, and like these side pieces are not small by any means. So overall, I think for retail price, it's a okay price per piece, but I actually got it for $70 at Target, and that kind of brings the price per piece below 10 cents, like 8 cents or something. And I feel like that's a great deal because this set has great minifigures, and there's just some great, like, prints, I'll say. I actually really like the prints right here. That's super cool, and it really looks good. So overall, I think the price per piece is okay for what they were asking for retail price, but if you can get it on sale for $70, I think you're really getting a deal there. So overall for the set, rating it, I'm feeling kind of split. It all depends on the type of person you are with your Lego sets. Like, are you the person who likes to play with them, or are you the person who likes to display them? For display, I'll give it like a 9 out of 10 or close to a 10 out of 10. I mean, I know people don't like the gap in the middle, but that's accurate and you can fill it out with characters. So I think it's a great display model. It looks really great. Like, these red things in between the windows, that just looks amazing. I don't know. I just love that building style. But if you were to play with this set, to be honest, you, like, can't, because it falls apart so much. Like, I don't know why it does that. It just does. Like, this piece is loose as we speak. It's kind of annoying. And the interior space is all right. It's kind of small. I wish there was, like, the elevator, like I said. So if you were to play with it, I would give it maybe, like, a 7 out of 10. But for display, oh my gosh, 10 out of 10. So there you have it, guys. That's my review of set number 76403, the Ministry of Magic. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.